Hey y'all, welcome back to Adventuring with Amanda. Thank you so much for being here. If you are new to my channel, welcome. Today I am packing up camp. I have been at this spot, excuse me, for about 11 days, and it is time to head home to my home base for a few days so I can get all my mail, get some stuff done. I have a lot of packages to pick up for both me and Maddie, and then I will be heading back up north. So this video will be a basically showing my entire process of breaking down camp. When I am somewhere for so long like this, you know, almost 2 weeks, I generally take out everything, set up everything. The only thing I did not take out was my shower tent because Maddie had his set up, so I've just been using his tent for my showers. But I will give you the entire breakdown, my process, how I do it. I like to get mostly packed up the day before I head out. That way I don't have a lot to stress about the next day. And I will dive a little deeper into that too, because there are some things that I will leave out until the next morning. So like this video and subscribe to my channel. Let's get started with that process. This is what my camp currently looks like with nothing packed up. So as you can see, I took out mostly everything from my rooftop box and put up my awning, all that good stuff. I even have decorative items out. So like I said, I will take a shower later, but I want to clean up my stuff, like my rug, get things put away in my rooftop box, because that generally gets me kind of dirty and I don't want to shower and get dirty again. So for my rooftop box, this is my shower water right here, but for my rooftop box, I have things like my cones, my lawn darts game, my rug, my broom. I have Wynston's playpen and my chair, but I will leave those things out until the morning. My water is one of the last things to pack up because I have to use my sink and water throughout the day. My awning also goes in my rooftop box, so I will take that down as well. Won't really need it today anyways. We're expecting 69 and sunny, I think. That's Maddie's table. I just used that to make my bacon. And then I also have my trash can over there, but I will dump trash tomorrow. And that's a collapsible bin. So after I dump trash, I will collapse it down and just leave it on the floor space of my van until I can put it back in my rooftop box. I did pack up my Van Power Solar. I've had it just sitting out. I haven't put it away in over a week. Well, actually, probably since I've been here. But I cleaned it off yesterday because I like to clean everything off before I put it in my van. So that will also be one of the last things to go in the van, because I put my aluminum table right here with my solar panels. That's my laundry bag. So again, everything's a process. But that's what this video is for. I do have my decorative items, like my Amanda and Wynston sign and my little candle, my little Target table I have going on over there. So that stuff goes inside the van. So to clean my sign, I actually do my little vacuum on it, because if I use like a Swiffer or something, it gets kind of stuck since it's wood. But I will put that on the side of my bed, put the decorative items in my van where they go. But I'm going to use that little table throughout the day, and that goes behind my fridge with my ramp. So those will be a couple things that I put in last. The ramp will definitely go in the van tomorrow morning when we're ready to head out. I unlocked my rooftop box from the back, but I'm 5'8", so I can easily get to my rooftop box on either side just by standing inside the door of my van. On this side, I put items that I don't use all the time, like my cones, and I'm putting my lawn darts in there as well. And then I put other items that I access frequently on the other side. I just filled my collapsible shower bucket with water, and I filled my little tea kettle with water because that's what I will heat up to add to the cold water. And now, as you can see, I have a little bit left in both of my jugs, so I will consolidate the two. That way I'm only traveling with, you know, one full 3-gallon, and I don't have to worry about like bungeeing
the other empty gallon. So I consolidate all of my water, and this also helps me know how much I need to fill up.
While I'm camping or I'm somewhere for a long time, I make notes of things that I need to restock on, especially when I am at a place for 11 days or something. I tend to run low on things, realize I need to do a restock. So I actually did a big Amazon restock the other day, so I will have that package waiting at my house. But as I'm cleaning up my van, I'm also realizing, like, oh, maybe I need this or maybe I need that, and I make a list of those things. So if there are things that maybe I forgot or just didn't realize or ran low on in the last couple of days before I made the Amazon purchase, I can do that while I'm at my home base. So I am a very organized person. I have a notebook and a planner that I'm constantly just writing lists and notes and things so I don't forget, but it is something that I'm very aware of while I'm packing up. For example, I need to refill all of my spray bottles when I'm home. So like my bleach, my vinegar and water mixture, and just my regular water bottle. So I need to refill those, like grab a new sponge, just little things like that that I don't want to forget. But I really enjoy the process. It kind of gives me like something else to do. So yeah, I will get the Amazon stuff when I get home and do all of that. And then since I just consolidated my water, I also cleaned off my water jugs, because one way I stay so clean is by, you know, wiping everything down, cleaning everything off before I put it in my van to keep the dust and the leaves and everything at a minimum.
I put my rug away before I shower because it was so dusty, so gross, like my hands and my arms got nasty from doing it. So folded it up. It is sitting in my rooftop box now. Next on my list, oh, look at all that dust, gross. Next on my list is to shower. That way I can clean up my portable shower and put that away with my bucket into my rooftop box. I decided that I want to get my solar packed away, and in order to do so, I need to put away this aluminum table. So I will keep my water out and my sink, but I can still use it without it being on top of this table. So of course, like everything else, I wipe it down with a Clorox wipe and then move the other items that are sitting in its space. It actually got kind of dirty, so I ended up taking a towel out so I could clean off the legs. That way I don't get a ton of dirt down inside my van where I can't often reach it. So I gave it a good cleaning and then I put it in there. That way I can put my Van Powers solar, my Yargo solar, and my laundry bag on top of it. So I just figured I would get it all cleaned up now, because why not? Something to do and get it out of the way. But like I said, I will leave my water in my sink out until the morning because I need to do things like wash my dishes, wash my hands, and brush my teeth. But now I have a majority of the work done and things are put away. I finished showering, so now I have my collapsible bucket out just drying in the sun, as well as my towels. I have a very full laundry bag for tomorrow. I won't be able to fit all my laundry in it, actually, but I am just slowly gathering everything as I continue on with my day. Doing a little bit at a time really helps me out because I don't get overwhelmed. And yeah, okay, I think that's it for now. All right, folks, this is where we are at with things. Wynston is in his playpen supervising me, but I still have his bed out and his toys. My solar lantern is charging. And then just the ramp, the water on the ground, I have my electric water dispenser charging as well. Of course, the awning is still up. I'll take that down later this afternoon. And then I have my little white table out, and just the chair and the playpen. So everything else is put away. Rooftop box still has the keys in it, but I just kind of like shut it a little bit because the wind was actually shifting it and shifting my rug inside. But so this is bare bones.
and I'll show you what it looks like when I take down the awning.
It is the morning of us heading out, and Maddie actually took down my awning for me. A little less work for me to do. I just put away my little white folding table and my water jug. So I have my bucket that I emptied that was from my sink, my chair, and Winston's playpen. Winston's playpen is typically the very last thing I put away. I shake off the tapestry, make sure there's no spiders or caterpillars or bugs on it. And then I will unzip the top of it, which it actually got kind of stuck. A bar of soap is really good for unsticking zippers, but it got kind of stuck. I managed to get it undone. And then I took out the towel because I will have to put that in the laundry. I have so much laundry to do. And then those are Winston's outdoor beds that I will put on top of the playpen and into the rooftop box. I give it a good shaking out. Collapse it, you know, just takes a few seconds. And then that, along with my chair, are the last things to go in. I didn't pack my bucket in my rooftop box on my way here, but I figured, you know what? I have the space. I'm actually just going to throw it in there because my rooftop box is tall enough to even fit a 5-gallon bucket. So I put my chair in and then put my bucket in. I had to adjust it a little bit, but it ended up working out and locked and closed just fine. The last thing, my collapsible trash bin that I will put right inside my van so I can dump it. Thank you so much for tuning into this video. I hope that it was helpful to you. If it was, be sure to give it a thumbs up. I'll see you next time.